Hi, welcome to our first video. I will guide you in your first steps to DSLR Booth. When you're starting up DSLR Booth for the first time, you are getting the welcome screen. On this page, you can see all the settings your event has enabled. This is the default page DSLR Booth will show you. You can turn this off in the settings later if you don't want to see this as a default page. This can be handy for when you deliver unattended photo booths. In this example, we have one event in our event list. You can delete it here if you like, or you can make a new one. In the middle, you can see your start screen settings that you have enabled. In this case, we only have the photo function enabled. We also have a disclaimer and survey active. In the upper right, we see the print settings we are using. In this case, the display print button is active. You also can see a preview of our photo layout we are using. The lower right, we can see which sharing functions we have active on the sharing page. More on this later. For this case, we are going to make a new event. Here, we create the name of our event. Choose a name you can easily remember. This will create a new folder in Windows with the same name, where your pictures and settings will be saved. You can start with Choose Launch Event or adjust all your settings first. As this is our first event, we'll configure it now. In the General tab on your left, you see the stats settings. Here you can see an overview of the uploaded and pending emails and more. You can export these settings or delete them here. If your emails are pending for a long time, you probably have a bad internet connection. Next is Booth Mode. Here you can activate which function you want to use. You can choose Photo, GIF, Boomerang, and Video. This will generate icons on your start screen that guests can touch to start the activation. If you are using the photo mode, it's also possible to automatically generate a GIF with the pictures you make. This will work best when you make at least 3 pictures, let's say when you make a photo strip. You can display the text labels under the icons if you want. Next is Options. Here you can enter a security PIN which you will need to exit to start screen, so guests can't exit the software by accident. Also, this is the place where you can turn the welcome screen off. Leave the virtual keyboard and hardware acceleration in the recommended default setting unless you have issues on older computers. The disclaimer setting is next. If needed, enable this and put here your disclaimer text that guests have to accept before using the photo booth. Under directories, you can find the data directory where your files and your pictures are saved. Standard it is in the pictures folder under Windows. You can change this. Use a non-removable drive and not a cloud drive, as this can give you issues when that directory is not found by a bad network connection. When you want to use a USB stick to give to your client after the event, or a network drive, you can use the real-time export function. Select your directory here. You can select which of the files you want to copy, like the print files with the layout included, or the originals, picture only, GIFs, and/or videos. The trigger option and API setting is for advanced users or programmers and make it, for example, possible to trigger external hardware like lights or other software applications. The camera setting. Here you find most camera-related settings. Auto trigger camera will make your camera make a picture. After the countdown hits 0, you will get a white screen when the camera triggers. You can easily replace this standard screen with a black screen if you don't like it, or make a screen with Smile Now or something you prefer. Enable webcams is nice as a backup when you use a Surface tablet and let's say your DSLR camera disconnect unexpectedly. Or when you use a webcam as main camera, activate this setting. Choose the best resolution for your webcam and audio input if this option is available for your device. Use Live View so the guest can see themselves when the countdown is running. Some older cameras can overheat when using this function. Mirror the image to get a preview, like looking in the screen of a mirror. This is easier for guests to position themselves when looking to the screen. You can rotate the live view in degrees when you place your camera on its side, for example. Display on start screen. Activate this when you want the camera to give a constant live view on the start screen. Also activate this when using the green screen function if you want your overlay to be shown on the start screen. The display setting. In the options, you can choose to start the app in full screen. Use this when you want to start up your computer, and everything should start up in a ready-to-use photo booth. We will explain in another tutorial how you can automatically start your computer and software when it's getting power, or after a power eruption so that everything is starting up automatically. This is a key function for unattended photo booths. You can choose the colors for text, buttons, and standard backgrounds here. Start screen. Choose your start screen image here, make it the same dimensions as the resolution of the screen you use. You can find these dimensions under screen setting in Windows. Under template, standard, you will find use last opened template. So when you open the software, the last settings are available, or you can let the guest choose from different templates you have activated in the template menu. We will discuss this later, how to set this up. Display browse button. When this is activated, you will have a small window in the upper left corner with all the pictures taken on the start screen. You can turn this off for most of the time as it will distract the guests when they have to touch the start screen, especially on mirror booths. You probably do not want this on a clean screen. The unlock button shows you the transparency of the lock sign in the upper right corner when your booth is locked. We make this completely transparent so guests never click on it. When you have a password entered, you will get a numeric screen where you can enter your code to exit the booth. You can start your session with these trigger options here. Guest QR code makes it possible to let the guest start the session with their phone through a QR code on the start screen. Good network Wi-Fi connection is important for this to work good. That's it for now. The next topics we will go through in the next videos. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.